For the sickest COVID-19 patients who are no longer able to breathe on their own, the drug dexamethasone offers a glimmer of hope.
This is the first medicine that's been shown to reduce death in any group with COVID, and that's the start of something.
In a large clinical trial, UK scientists gave 2,000 COVID-19 patients a low dose of dexamethasone. Results suggest the drug saved one life for every 8 patients on a ventilator and saved one life for every 25 receiving oxygen.
I'm just eternally grateful and will be for the rest of my life.
Catherine Milbank spent 12 agonizing days on a ventilator before receiving the drug. She left the hospital on her 55th birthday.
I wouldn't be here, I wouldn't be alive. So, thank you.
Doctors worldwide are excited about this development. This drug is a common corticosteroid, often prescribed to patients with arthritis and asthma. It's available in every hospital pharmacy, and it's cheap. The only problem is researchers haven't yet released their data so that it can be reviewed.
I think there will be some devil in the details when the final publication comes out. It's very hard to practice medicine from press release.
Still, Britain's health minister has granted doctors permission to start giving the drug to all severely ill COVID-19 patients. Canada's top doctor isn't there yet.
It's very important for us to actually examine the results very carefully before making any further recommendations.
We're not talking about some trivial outcome.
But some doctors say they won't wait.
I think that most clinicians who become aware of this study are going to start using it today.
Doctors emphasize dexamethasone won't protect anyone from becoming infected with COVID-19, but they hope it will be the first of many drugs that will save lives. Christine Birak, CBC News, Toronto.
Now, Dr. Samir Gupta is a respirologist who's been following this development very closely. And so let me ask you, why isn't Canada moving more aggressively on using dexamethasone? I mean, what's the downside?
Well, I think right now we have a press release. We don't have a study yet. So we're going to want to see that study. As a clinician, I'm going to want to make sure that there were no sources of bias that crept into that study, that it was conducted properly. And the second reason is that, you know, we can't take this drug lightly. Steroids do have side effects. We've studied them extensively in patients in the ICU. They cause patients' sugars to go up. They cause a loss of muscle mass. They cause people to become confused in the ICU. They also, over time, quite ironically, predispose to other infections. So if the effect size is what it is, then we would put those side effects aside. But we want to know that for sure. We want to see the trial.
So then what is your best guess then as to a timeline for when we would see this used more widely in Canada?
I think very likely, Andrew, we're going to see this used widely the day the trial comes out. The reality is that we're desperate right now. People are using drugs like remdesivir, tocilizumab, in many cases what we call off-label, so we don't have the indication, we don't have strong trial data. Here we have a drug that apparently is showing a benefit in terms of mortality, which none of the other drugs have done so far, and in the sickest patients, patients in the ICU on a ventilator, and those are the patients we're desperate to help. 40% of those people are dying.
Right.
If we can affect that mortality rate, we're going to be using this overnight.
Dr. Gupta, very good to talk to you. Thank you.
And you. Thank you.